Hoy contamos con Kate Mead, vicepresidenta, directora y estratega de inversiones de AllianceBernstein. Hi, Kate. Thanks for coming here for Negocios TV. It's a pleasure having you here.
Hi, it's lovely to be here.
Kate, artificial intelligence or AI seems to be everywhere right now. What factors are fueling the current surge in artificial intelligence adoption? And is this different from previous waves of AI development?
Yeah, you're absolutely right. AI seems to have gone from a buzzword that's everywhere to a daily business reality. And it does feel like that momentum is growing exponentially. Certainly, I feel like every day I'm in the office, there seems to be a new use case or a new tool to trial. And here at AllianceBernstein, we have described this rise in AI as being turbocharged adoption. And so thinking about what's driving this, we have seen several things come together all at once that seems to be really pushing this adoption. And I think, firstly, AI has become so accessible to everybody. You and I and millions of other people are using AI daily, and you don't even need to have a very technical background. So the launch of tools such as ChatGPT have captured public imagination, both for individuals and businesses alike. And I think this has really demonstrated the application of AI in everyday opportunities and applications. And secondly, something else that's been really supportive of this adoption is advances in hardware and cloud computing. And this has made training and deploying new models much faster and also cheaper. So these advances combined with the availability of massive data sets, for example, and also we're seeing significant investments from both the private sector, but also sovereigns and the public sector. And thirdly, there seems to be a competitive rush. Every business seems to be talking about how they're going to incorporate AI and reap the benefits of AI, whether that's as an adopter of the technology or an enabler. So all of this has led to a really interesting pace of adoption, which is very turbocharged, as I said up front. And we're seeing businesses operate AI into their daily operations and also across their products and services. And from an investment standpoint, it is an exciting story, but it is a little bit uneven. We've seen market returns are dominated by a handful of very large cap tech names. So the key for investors now is separating that short-term hype from companies that will have long-term AI advantages, either through enabling or adopting these technologies.
And Kate, when we talk about the AI, it clearly has the potential to bring efficiency gains, but it's also incredibly resource intensive. How do you think about that tension?
You are so right. It is a double-edged sword. And as you say, AI has the potential to be an opportunity, but also a risk. When we think about material financial risks for investors, a key concern is the significant amount of energy consumption that's required to train and run large AI models. And the data centers that support those AI applications are extremely energy intensive. And as that AI adoption grows, based on some of those factors we've just talked about, the demand for electricity grows as well. And I'll just give you a quick example. In 2022, data centers made up about 2% of global electricity demand. And some projections estimate this could be as much as 7% by 2030. And when we look at the US, where a huge amount of these data centers are being built, there are already six states that consume more than 10% of the electricity supply. And Virginia, actually 25% of their energy is consumed by data centers, according to some studies. And so beyond energy, we've actually seen previous technological disruptions can involve a shift in the workforce as well. So that's beyond energy. We're thinking about jobs lost, but also potentially gained. And we'll probably see a change in the composition of the workforce as well, whether that's through the type of work being undertaken or the change in roles. And so that might be AI related fields or AI adjacent, where we see some of that new employment. And we don't yet know how that will shake out, but we'll certainly be watching that sort of risk and piece of the business as well. And I think finally, something that's also been a risk that's been highlighted around AI is some of that misinformation and disinformation. And that's something that we've already seen discussed around the rise of social media. So those are some key risks that we might think about as investors and also users of the technology. But we also see lots of opportunities. So I've already mentioned energy, for example. So companies who are building the power infrastructure, they're running high power voltage cables, for example. We might also see those enablers as winning and as good opportunities as well. But it's really important also to think about how AI can solve some of our big global problems. And that can include some of these environmental challenges I've already referenced. We can think about the huge amounts of information AI can help us to use to optimize energy grids, for example, or thinking even about social issues like advancing medical research. So, in our view, investors should monitor these developments, both across the risks and also the opportunities.
Kate, we have a lot of questions about the AI. How are companies and investors responding to the sustainability challenges posed by the AI? And what is the best practice? What are the best practices which are emerging about it?
That's a great question. And let's not forget, although lots of us are using AI on a day-to-day basis, we're still actually very early in the AI journey, and it's also evolving very rapidly. So when we think about engaging with businesses and management teams, we're really looking to understand how businesses are thinking about these risks and also how they're going to be managing those risks today and as we move into the future. So, energy is something that's been a big topic of today's conversation. So, we're thinking about those hyperscalers. How are they reinforcing their resilience against some of the energy risks? So, we're thinking about, are they investing in energy efficient data centers? How are they seeking to power their operations, for example? Is that with energy efficient resources? And we've also seen a focus on developing more efficient AI algorithms, for example, that require less computational power. So from an active management perspective, we're thinking about those companies that are taking steps towards improving energy efficiency and improving their footprint, not only in their own operations, but also across their supply chains. And then when we think about the risks of AI adoption at a business level, we want to understand from businesses how are they implementing governance frameworks when it comes to thinking about AI. We have seen some companies making AI a board level issue, and what we've seen is they're thinking really carefully about data privacy, how they think about the impact of automation on the business, for example, as a risk as well as an opportunity. And I think it's really important that boards are responsive and forward-thinking, because poor governance could turn into a regulatory or a reputational issue fairly quickly. But we're certainly seeing lots of firms being quite forward-thinking on some of these issues and setting clear targets and collaborating with their stakeholders, as well as thinking about the best industry standards for AI development. So definitely a space to watch.
Kate, when we try to navigate this fast-moving space, how can investors participate in the opportunities provided by the AI revolution and try to do it responsibly?
So AI isn't going anywhere, and so it seems like a really exciting investment opportunity to embrace. As we've seen, AI has the potential to transform many areas of life, and particularly within businesses, whether that's HR functions or marketing, but also across every industry as well. So thinking about manufacturing or healthcare. So we can't ignore the opportunity. It is really an exciting place to be. we need to think about, as investors, looking beyond the hype and thinking about the deeper questions that we can ask. So who is building durable and real-world applications of AI? Who's integrating sustainable risk management practices, thinking about incorporating environmental issues as well as data ethics and transparency? And so the pace of AI adoption is extraordinary, but the real winners will be those that are able to combine that innovation with responsibility, and long term, that should provide resilient and durable investment opportunities.
Bueno, pues la inteligencia artificial, que sin duda es uno de los puntos a tener en cuenta, uno de los focos de los inversores. Kate, thanks for being here in Negocios TV. It's a pleasure having you here. Thank you. Thank you so
Thank
much.
you.